Whoa, it's your boy Praying and Rose. We are back with another video, man. And today, but listen, we got a banger for today's video, man. But recently, man, y'all been showing your boy so much support. So y'all already know what y'all gotta do, bruh. Turn that like button to a Super Saiyan Blue, man. We gotta get 1,000 likes on this video. And listen, if you let Bobbity put an M on your forehead, you are trash. You are weak. Capital K, weak. We don't want you here. Hit an instant transmission off my video. You're just stop. All right, bro. Like I said, I ain't gonna keep you up for too long, bro. We got a banger today, man. So let's go ahead and get to the video, bro. So listen, y'all, we already know that Bandai Namco, aka the Hercule of the community, because all they want is our Zenny, my guy. We already know they dropped the new DLC for Xenoverse 2. Just a quick reminder, bro, if you haven't seen it, man, I streamed the free update and the DLC. Make sure y'all go check that out, bro. It is out right now. Make sure you go crazy. But we gotta get into the crazy stuff about this DLC. Now, this is the main part that I wanted to pay attention to in the DLC, was the story mode. Now, y'all know my boy Fu going crazy, bro. He messing up the Gogeta fight and Broly fight, bringing in Kale and Khalifa, bro. Not Khalifa. Is it Khalifa? It's Khalifa. I'm sorry. But Kale and Khalifa, bro, they fusing, going crazy, bro. And like, he just messing up the timeline each and every time. You got Jiren and Broly about to go at it, bro. Now, listen, this is crazy, bro. This is actually crazy. Because if you really pay attention to it, bro, Fu is breaking so many timelines, it is actually impossible to fix, my guy. He broke multiple timelines. He broke the main story timeline. He broke the this was going on right here, previous DLCs. He just broke so many, bringing Janemba, future Gohan. You know, it's crazy, bro. It is crazy. He's just breaking so many things. It's kind of impossible to fix. And only way to stop it is to beat him. And everybody know, if you haven't played the DLC, a little spoiler alert, you do not defeat Fu. Fu just keeps opening up different portals. Look, I don't know what this is. He did this in the last DLC. I don't know if these are different dimensions opening up or what, bro. And I don't know. You saw he hopped back in the portal and he came into this timeline. And plus, if you ever realize, bro, after the DLC, they never fixed the timeline. He just leaves and it goes to a different timeline. He never fixed that. So it's like, Broly's still fighting Jiren right now. You get what I'm saying? They never sent them back to where they're supposed to be at. It's always just there. It's just happening like right now. You get what I'm saying, bro? Now, this is the most interesting one right here, when Trunks is trying to save everything, because Fu really tried to end it all, bro. He went back to Bardock. He tried to get Bardock out of there or do something or kill Frieza, whatever he was trying to do, whatever his part is playing, and Trunks tried to stop him. Now, this was the biggest one in the story, because this is the only timeline they kind of fixed, bro. If you ever realize it, like I said in the beginning of the video, man, after Fu do what he do, he just leaves. Like the Janemba one, when all the Janembas came, you beat him, future Gohan was still there. He opened up a new portal and left. The Broly and Jiren one and Kefla one, they all are still there, bro. This is the only one that it actually happened the way it's supposed to happen. It happened a different way, but it happened. You get what I'm saying, bro? Frieza killed Bardock. He got dropped off, went back to the thing. He died. And after that, Trunks and Fu, I think they went their separate ways, and Fu went to a different timeline. They didn't show what timeline he went to. But now, if you do not know, this was very weird for Bandai to do. This is very weird. This is the first time they ever did some crazy stuff like this. You get what I'm saying? They did a secret cut scene in Xenoverse 3. Now, you might have already saw it. I'm gonna let it play in the background, my guy. The secret cut scene is when Bardock goes Super Saiyan against Frieza. This was kind of different, bro, because this cut scene right here, this one's kind of different. How to trigger it, bro? All you had to do was die when Trunks showed up, and you had to die, then it would have triggered this cut scene. But me thinking is like, why would you put this in there? You get what I'm saying? If the timeline went regularly from the main story, you get what I'm saying? It went regular back. Bardock got dropped off and everything. We had to die in order for Bardock to go Super Saiyan and finish him. Well, he went half Super Saiyan, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if he was just feeling the power like Vegeta, or he actually went Super Saiyan, but you'll see it right here in a minute. But like I'm saying, why would you put that in there? This is something very interesting. And Frieza went final form, Frieza off the rip, dropped him off, punched him in the chin, and after that, he's gonna give him a little speech and he's gonna throw his little riot javelin. You get what I'm saying, bro? So I really wanna know, what does this really mean? Because after you beat the mission, all it says is retry. It doesn't like continue off of this storyline. It doesn't continue off this timeline. You get what I'm saying, bro? You gotta retry and do it again, stay alive and beat it. But my thing is, why put this in here for it? Why put this in? Like, you took your time to make a whole cutscene us losing, and he goes Super Saiyan, something that everybody wanted to see and stuff like that. I don't understand, like, what was the point of putting this in there? Now, y'all know my big theory about the Xenoverse 3 thing is I really think they're going to go into Dragon Ball Heroes. That's the timeline I'm thinking, because like I said, Fuu, Supreme Kai Tom, Xeno Trunks, and all of that, Xeno Bardock is part of Xenoverse. That's not Xenoverse. They're part of Dragon Ball Heroes. You get what I'm saying, bro? I really think they're going to go into that. And this is the perfect time. I feel like they're building up to something big and big and big for the next game. They're trying to get this timeline all messed up in Xenoverse 2 and Xenoverse 3. I think we're going to have to go back and fix everything, like, again. You get what I'm saying? Because, like I said, it doesn't make sense. He never fixed them. After you beat it, it just stays the same. He go to a different portal. You really think Dragon Ball just gonna let that slide? You know what I'm saying? You gonna have to fix it some way and somehow to go back to the regular timeline of Dragon Ball Z. So they're doing a good job with this route, bro. They are actually doing a good job. I'm kind of excited. Like, this is the most time I've ever been engaged into a Dragon Ball story to see what happens, see where do Fu goes next, because this is very exciting, bro. It really is. So hoping that, I don't know how they're going to do this next game, because I know they got more DLCs coming out, bro. They might do one more again, then continue to the next thing, or you know what's banned out, my God. This game might long lasts than GTA. We don't know. But I'm saying, bro, this is the perfect time to set up for a new story mode game. You know what I'm saying? Because it's so perfect. It's actually perfect. It is interesting. It's just not the same Dragon Ball Z story. You wonder what happened next. A whole bunch of stuff is messed up, but look, I just hope they do this right, man. So let me know in the comment section below. Please let me know, bro. This is a perfect setup for Xenoverse 3 or for the next Dragon Ball Z game. So please let me know in the comment section below. But if I miss anything, let me know. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe if you're new. And I'm out, bro. I'm out.